Well, here we go again. Cue the intro. I don't have an intro. Hello, this is gonna be my last video of the year. I didn't think I would make a video this year. I thought it was gonna start in January. But there's been a lot of crazy stuff happening on Broadway, and I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I've been wanting to upload a video for a while. I'm sorry I don't have the New York vlog thing up yet. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and make this video. It's kinda last minute, and I do wanna upload something before the end of the year. So it may not be the most edited or prepared, but I hope you're okay with that. I hope you're okay with me just making some kind of content. Because some crazy stuff has happened and I'm looking at my notes because I wrote notes. By the way, I want to say thank you for 200 subscribers. It may go back down to 199 or something by the time this is uploaded. I don't know, but I just randomly hit 200 subscribers recently when I haven't been uploading at all. Some of my videos, I guess, were picking up some views. I guess the Shrek one and the How to Get on Broadway one. And if you're subscribed from there, hello, thank you for subscribing. This is me trying to keep the channel alive. In January, I will be much more intentional about doing that. But for now, I just want to talk about some crazy stuff that's happening, particularly around Omicron, because apparently I was very lucky that I went in November, because in December is when everything went to poop. We have, most recently in the news, Hugh Jackman, who's playing Harold Hill on the Music Man revival, tested positive for COVID, and I think Sutton Foster did as well a little earlier. So now that both leads are out, they're just going to close the show until January 6th. And that's been happening for a lot of shows, a lot of shows that have suffered. I think the first one was Jagged Little Pill. It was like earlier this month. But other shows that were affected by Omicron, these are just some of them. Dear Evan Hansen, Hamilton, Ain't Too Proud, which is closing soon. On a scheduled close, it wasn't closing because of Omicron, but it's closing like in January. But they still had to close some performances because of Omicron. And what I mean by that is some cast members and maybe even some crew members tested positive and they couldn't get any standbys or understudies because either they also tested positive or it was so quick in advance that it didn't work. The details actually are more explained in depth, like on an industry level, from Amy Lovett. If you want to look up her video, I think it's the most recent one as of this uploading. She does a video about how all that stuff works in the industry. But these are shows where they had to close some performances because someone tested positive for COVID, Omicron specifically. I'm guessing Hadestown, Aladdin, Lion King, Mrs. Doubtfire, Harry Potter and the Cursed Child, and Accursed Child, excuse me, and Six, among the ones I just mentioned, of course. And there's probably more, but those are the ones that were the most notable that hit the news. And also, much more than just closing performances, two shows had to actually close their doors early. There were shows that were set to close early in 2022, but had to close because they were just having so many closures from Omicron, and you lose a lot of money when you close even one performance. You can lose like $250,000 just from closing one performance. So Waitress and Thoughts of a Colored Man, I put it in an acronym, TOACM, and I was like, what does that stand for? That show closed. I'm not good at this whole non-editing stuff. They posted on their social media apologies that they were gonna have to be closing early and how sad they were. But it was kind of more of a matter of weeks. It's not like any show that was just like set to be running forever just closed permanently or something. It wasn't like Hadestown or something. So luckily, I guess that's good-ish. But I wanna know what your thoughts are on whether or not Broadway should be open. Is this proof that Broadway opened too soon? Do you think it's all kind of understated? Do you think if they're vaccinated, we shouldn't be closing performances? I know the CDC also recently reduced the amount of time you should be quarantined if you're vaccinated to 5 days when it was originally 10 days. Do you think that should apply here? And that's really all I wanted to talk about. I didn't have any other major thoughts. I just wanted to mention that because I was just casually, you know, toilet scrolling on my phone and would just be seeing these news stories pop up on my Google recommendeds because I look at this stuff a lot and being like, wow, Broadway is kind of shutting down again. But it's almost in like a forced way. It's like a slow death rather than in 2020 where it was just like, I think like maybe one or two shows closed and then eventually all of Broadway was just shut down all at once. And this time it's like happening very slowly. Do you think this is a slow, we're slowly getting to the same point that eventually like March 2022 or something, we're just gonna be all closed again? Do you think this is gonna blow over? Do you think this is an overreaction? I wanna know what your thoughts are. And I just wanted to say hi and thank you for subscribing, people, even though I haven't been uploading and I've been a very bad YouTuber. I was doing finals this week. I had a Christmas trip thing. And it was very busy. This is like the first week where I've been able to really upload. And with a couple of exceptions, I can already tell this video is going to be, I'm going to try and make it not so edited, because editing is the thing that makes it really hard for me to make videos. Like, that's the thing in my mind when I think of making a video. I'm like, oh, but I don't want to sit at my computer and edit. That's so painful and annoying, because I have to listen to myself and judge myself. Like, oh, that sounded stupid, I'm gonna cut that. And it's like my mind is weird things when I edit, so I don't enjoy that process. So I'm trying to make these videos just kind of on the fly, and I'm not good at it right now, but that's fine. I'm just trying to get better. I know I talk a little too fast, and I'm not the smoothest at coming up with stuff, so bear with me on that. But I just want to say hi and thank you, and I want to know what your thoughts are on all these crazy closures happening due to Omicron. And with that said, I think that's about it. Thank you. I guess I'll throw in some other stuff. I'm gonna be in a show. I'll give you more details on that later if you're interested. And I'm seeing Hamilton in here in Fresno, and I might do a little review of that when it comes out. Okay, I'm just gonna be done because I'm done talking. Once again, thanks for watching, and with that said, keep loving theater. I'll see you next time. That's it. That's all I have to say. Okay.